The first jigsaw puzzle was invented in Europe in 1760. Nearly two centuries later, a Canadian inventor reshaped the popular pastime. His puzzle pieces, made of thick foam rather than cardboard, could stand upright, turning the puzzle into a three-dimensional model. Constructing a 3D puzzle produces impressive results. To do so, two 800-piece puzzle sets are used to create this spectacular castle replica. An industrial designer creates the puzzle's three-dimensional structure. An illustrator uses techniques such as visual textures and shading to transform flat graphics into a three-dimensional rendering. The industrial designer prepares the printing and cutting layout, fitting up to three puzzles per sheet. The puzzle pieces are made from rigid foam. The foam is specifically engineered to be chemically compatible with the paper graphics and proprietary adhesive. A technician feeds one sheet at a time into a custom-designed lamination machine. The first station spreads hot glue over the top of the foam sheet. An automated arm with vacuum suction cups lifts a single sheet of printed paper and places it on the glue-coated foam sheet. As soon as the paper adheres to the foam, the sheet is released from the suction cups. Then the foam moves under a roller that presses down the paper. As the laminated foam exits the machine, a technician rolls a tube over the foam, pressing out any remaining air bubbles to ensure the paper adheres fully. In the development phase, the industrial designer assembled a blueprint for how the puzzle pieces would be shaped and laid out. That design went to a toolmaker who produced a corresponding cutting die out of steel knives. The die is mounted inside the cutting machine. A technician feeds the machine one laminated foam sheet at a time, paper side down. Grippers grab the edge of the paper, pulling the sheet into the machine. The cutting die slices the puzzle pieces into the foam. Even though the cutting pressure compresses the foam, it immediately bounces back, keeping the sheet intact. Thanks to a high-quality rubber sheet inserted between the blades, the pieces don't get stuck in the die. The stiff rubber provides counter pressure to help remove the foam sheet. If the sheet has two or three puzzles printed on it, the cutting die separates them. Then, a technician places the puzzle on a semi-automatic conveyor belt that moves it to the dismantling machine. The machine infuses the die-cut puzzle sheet with steam. The steam prevents static electricity, which causes pieces to cling together or to the inside of the machine. The machine separates the pieces and dispenses them into a puzzle box. A technician adds the standard instruction sheet and seals the box. The instructions are in black and white, but can be viewed in color online. The first step is to sort the pieces by color and design and set aside the ones marked with a red dot, which is part of the manufacturing process, not the puzzle itself. The next step is to assemble the puzzle section by section. All the sections are flat, so the final step is to attach the flat sections to make the puzzle three-dimensional. For an additional challenge, you can forego the step-by-step instructions and refer only to the photos on the box. If you happen to lose a puzzle piece, you can go to the company's website to trace the number of your missing piece. Then order a new piece online. The company will mail it to you so that you can complete your puzzle. Unlike a traditional flat puzzle, you can move your 3D puzzle without it falling apart. It takes 4 to 6 months to develop and design this incredible 3D puzzle. Now it's time to spend even longer piecing this puzzle together.